What is population health? You might find different answers from different people. For me, it really is about aggregating data or understanding how we're taking care of a number of people in aggregate that might have the same condition, for example, and then understanding the differences across that population, both in the disease as well as the treatment. So the importance of focusing on population health is really because a couple of things. One thing we have noticed is that practitioners or the same people or the same populations with the same diseases or disorders are actually cared for differently across the nation, with even though they're being paid by the same payer. This was work that was done, resulted in a publication that was controversial in a way. But it was very clear that different communities take care of patients differently, and there are also different outcomes. So it'd be important to try to standardize and get best practices and understand what we're doing across the populations by looking at how people are taking care of the same type of patient across the country. So the relationship between health IT, if you will, and care improvement, I guess, is a question. I think there's a pretty direct correlation. We've seen, there have been several studies that have shown that looking at or using technology in a particular way does improve patient care. Physician order entry, for example, by Bates, has been repeatedly studied showing decreased adverse events in using medications in patients. So there's a clear relationship. There are also some that aren't as clear. So sometimes we do things just because they're technology and we introduce them, we think we're doing things better, and sometimes that's not the case. So we really need to take a close look at when we do something that we really validate our assumptions about the technology actually improving a process, rather than just making, as Dr. Kaiser mentioned, a bad process faster. Sometimes you have to re-engineer the process, and that includes technology in doing that. I think the immunization registry is such a necessary tool, really, for a variety of reasons that were actually outlined earlier. One of which is, I think a lot of people don't realize how much loss of productivity, if you will, or what the cost is related to just information handling around immunizations with schools. Schools need to know that information. They don't have a place to go get it. They have to ask the parent to go to the doctor to go get a piece of paper. It would be so much simpler if a school system could connect to the immunization registry and get the immunization record for the child and actually insert that into their system, for example, in an electronic fashion. All that handling would go away. And I saw a study a while back, an estimation that nationwide that process around just that costs somewhere on the order of $300 million a year. Yeah, including using up physician time and healthcare professional time to get the piece of paper. That should probably not have to happen that way. We'd rather be concentrating on how to improve immunization rates, not handling pieces of paper back to school.